The key scripture reading is from the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 1. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm sure that we all understand that how precious is our freedom in Christ. If you understand, then say amen.
Amen.
How costly is our freedom in Christ? And how permanent is our freedom in Christ? How sure of our freedom in Christ? How everlasting our freedom in Christ? Amen. We are justified just because of our faith in the shed blood on the cross. Amen. And not keeping any law. I want to quickly run through the word today as the time is very short for us. But with the available time, whatever scripture we can read today and understand, we will do it. Amen. Hallelujah. We will also learn that we are no longer obligated to follow any law. Amen. Today morning, I was listening to the Prime Minister's speech. I always listen. I am a little patriotic, by the way. So I was listening to the Prime Minister's speech where he was saying that I am prime servant of this country. I am not a prime minister. I am Pradhan Sevak Hen. That's what he said. Amen. And when he can say that I am the prime servant of this nation, which is going to vanish away one day, it actually touched my spirit. I said, then how much I should say that I am the prime servant for the kingdom of God. For that everlasting kingdom, there is no end to that kingdom. Amen. When for the world this man can say that I am a prime servant, it called me to say that I am a prime servant for my kingdom, for Jesus' kingdom. Amen. And he also said that I'm saluting those people who brought this freedom for our country. I said, how much more I should salute my Jesus who bought my freedom free of cost. It didn't freedom. I really want to salute our Savior. I want to salute my Redeemer. I want to salute the one who bought our freedom today. Amen. Hallelujah. He was talking about advancing the nation, India, which in any way will be destroyed one day. Amen. I said to myself that how much more I have to think, I have to work to advance the kingdom of God. Amen. This is God in my spirit. I said, Lord, when Narendra Modi can talk to advance the nation of India, then how much more you and me, who has been set free by the blood of Jesus, has to advance the kingdom of God. Amen. Why don't you give a clap offering to Jesus for all this? I tell you, with Jesus, there is a way out for every sinner. There is a way out for every murderer. There is a way out for every adulteress. There is a way out for every angry person. There is a way out for every guilty person. There is a way out for anything and everything with Jesus. Galatians 5:19 is not there for you on the screen. It says, if you do not stand firm in the freedom that is bought for you and me in Christ, then we cannot inherit the kingdom of God. If you go home, I want to just tell you, go home and read the Galatians chapter 5 completely, completely. In fact, Galatians, the book of Galatians itself, you should read completely. Then you will understand what kind of freedom God has given us. Amen. Hallelujah. We are all called citizens of heavenly kingdom. Amen. To have the citizenship of any nation, you have to pay a price. I have one person who is from Syria in my hotel, and since there is a lot of turmoil going on in Syria, he is trying for another citizenship in another country, for which he has to spend about 200,000 dirhams. But here, our Jesus, without paying any price, he has given you the freedom so freely, he has shed his blood so freely for you and me. And before we could understand who this Jesus is, he shed the blood on the cross for you and me to set us free. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us read the first scripture for today as the topic is stand firm in the freedom of Christ. The first scripture for today, which is a key scripture for our learning, is Galatians chapter 5 verse 1, which says, stand fast therefore in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage. To understand this verse, I would like to just remind you about the few scriptures Galatians chapter 4, where I observed that Paul asked the people to stand strong in the doctrine of grace rather than turning back to the law. In the last few verses of Galatians 4, he used Isaac and Ishmael as examples of sons born unto two systems. Isaac being the son of faith, typifying grace, and Ishmael being son of born woman and representing the law. And concluded that we are children of faith, we are children of promise, we are children of grace and not of law. I want to read a few scriptures from Galatians chapter 4. Verse 24 says, which things are symbolic for these are two covenants, the one from Mount Sinai, which gives birth to bondage, which is Hagar. For this Hagar is Mount Sinai in Arabia and corresponds to Jerusalem, which now is and is in bondage with our children, but the Jerusalem above is free, which is the mother of all. Amen. Verse 28 says, now we, brethren, as Isaac was, are children of promise. Can somebody say that I'm children of promise this evening? You and me can boldly say that we are children of promise. And verse 29 says, as he who was born according to the flesh then persecuted him who was born according to the spirit, even so it is now. Even so it is now. Even today there is persecution for the people of promise. Amen. Nevertheless, verse 30 says, what does the scripture say? Cast out the born woman and her son, for the son of born woman shall not inherit with the son of free woman. We can boldly say that I am heir with the son of free woman.
Yes.
Verse 31 says, so then, brethren, we are not children of born woman, but of the free.
Amen.
We are children of freedom. Can somebody shout, I am children of freedom. Amen.
Then
we are reminded again through Galatians chapter 5 verse 1. Let us stand fast, firm to our freedom in Christ. Amen. Paul continues with this concept of freedom in Galatians chapter 4 and commands us, Galatians chapter 5 verse 1, and telling us today to stand firm in our freedom which Christ has bought for us. From this perspective of looking back to our past life, when we were without Christ, we are going to see now what all the things we are being set free in Christ. This is just a reminder for you and me to look and check what and all God has set us free today. We are being set free from sin. If you agree with me, come on, say amen.
Amen.
We are being set free from guilt. We are being set free from the wrath of God. We are being set free from the dominion of Satan. We are being set free from the traditions of men. We are being set free from the work of the flesh. We are being set free from the fear of death. We are being set free from the law and curse. Amen. So we are called to stand firm in all those freedoms which we are going to see the scripture reference for. What and all I said you now. Amen. Romans chapter 6 verses 16 to 18 says in this manner.
Yes,
do you not know that to whom you present yourself slaves to obey, you are that one slave whom you obey, whether of sin leading to death or of obedience leading to righteousness? But God be thanked that though you were slaves of sin, yet you obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine to which you were delivered. And having been set free from sin, you became slaves to righteousness. Amen. Say, I'm set free from sin.
I'm set free from sin.
Since the old man, which was crucified when we were buried in baptism, our sin was crucified. It is like Christ was buried and he rose again with the newness of life, like that you and me have been set free from sin and we are now living in the newness of life which Christ has blessed us with.
Yeah.
So Paul is calling us today in Galatians 5:1. Stand fast to the freedom for which Christ shed his blood on the cross. Amen. We are now slaves to righteousness and not to sin.
Yeah.
We are being set free from guilt, I said. Reference scripture is Hebrews chapter 10, verses 19 to 22. The four brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh, and having the high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts If you agree with me, say amen. I better stand to that boldness. If I want to say that stand firm in the freedom, I better stay in the boldness which Christ has bought for me. We are called to enter boldly into His presence without any guilt in our heart. When we come boldly to His presence, that is what we are called to. That is the freedom Christ has bought for you and me. Not to stand in the old guilt which we buried in the baptism. We are called to come boldly, and we are called to align our walk with God. If we don't stand free and standing in the guilt, then we have not accepted the freedom which Christ has blessed us with. Amen. So if anybody in our midst having any kind of guilt, remove it right now in the name of Jesus, and enter boldly into the presence of God. Amen. Hallelujah. If we are not in communion with God, then we do, when we boldly go into His presence, what we do? We commune with Him. If we are not communing with Him, then we cannot come out of that guilt feeling. Amen. So we have to have free communion with God, and then we receive that freedom. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why He has provided us with the blood of Jesus. Amen. If there is any guilt, we have the blood of Jesus which covers every guilt. Hallelujah. We know that the veil in the temple was torn long time back so that we can enter boldly into His presence. Then why we should carry any guilt when we come into His presence? So today, Paul is calling you and me to stand firm in the freedom when we are being set free from the guilt and enter boldly into His presence through the blood of Jesus. Number three, we are being set free from the wrath of God.
Man.
Hebrews chapter 10 verses 26 and 27 says, "For if we sin willfully after we have received the knowledge of the truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins." This is very tough scripture, I would say. "But a certain fearful expectation of judgment and fear indignation which will devour the adversaries." Amen. This is very frightening scripture for me. So today, Paul is calling you and me to stand firm in the freedom wherein we are being set free from every wrath of God. Amen. So that we don't do any willful sins. Being the children of freedom, we will abstain from any willful sins, because the scripture is very frightening. If I willfully enter into any sin after being set free, then there is no forgiveness of sin. There is no washing of thing. I mean, you are putting God again on the cross. That is what I understand from the scripture. That willfully, if I am entering into any sin, once I am set free by the blood of Jesus, then there is no remission available for you and me. So let's stand fast in the freedom which Christ has bought for you and me, and remain abstain from doing any kind of willful sins. Amen. We have been set free from the dominance of Satan. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14 says, "In as much then as the children are partaken of flesh and blood, he himself likewise shared in the same, that through death he might destroy him who had the power of death." That is the devil. Devil is the one who brings spiritual death in people's lives. "Hence God took the form of flesh and blood and died in your place and my place, and went to the beast and destroyed the one death." Amen. He already did the job. He already set you free from that spiritual death. So stand firm today, because God has set free. God has set us free from the dominance of Satan. Let us stand firm in that freedom today, and let us not go back to that old life and go into that spiritual death. Amen. Hallelujah. And next number is, we have been set free from traditions of men. Nobody can know about traditions rather than Hindus. Because we are all coming from that background, we know a lot of traditions we are really following. Traditions of men we are really following before. But here in Galatians chapter 4 verse 9 to 11 it says, "But now after you have known God, or rather are known by God, how is it that you turn into weak and beggarly elements?" This is again a strong word. Don't turn to weak and beggarly elements of men's tradition. This is what it is calling you. "To which you desire again to be in bondage." Those traditions of men is called bondage in the scripture. And God has us. So the scripture is calling us, do not go back to the traditions of men. Verse 10 says, you observe days and months and seasons and years. I really remember all those olden days wherein in Hinduism you have Raghu Kalam, Yamagandham, lots of stuff for there. Like we see the time, whether this is a good time to do this job, whether this is a good time to go here and there. I mean, they were all those things we were following. And God is clearly saying that you don't follow those traditions of men because I have set you free from all those bondages. This is a day that the Lord has made and you will rejoice. Men. These verses refers to our earlier life when we were without Christ and we were involved in traditions, we were involved in religion, which are referred in the scriptures as weak and beggarly elements and bondage. Amen? Observing days, observing seasons, observing years ought to be observed by the people who are following religion and law. Amen? We are not to follow all those stuff. We are supposed to say, this is the day that the Lord has made and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen? Such things has no power to deliver our souls. Traditions of men has got no power that you can be delivered. Verse 11 says, I am afraid for you, lest I have labored for you in vain. This verse tells us that labor in the Lord is in vain if we turn away from the truth. And that is what I understand from verse 11. If I go out of the freedom from which God has set me free, then whatever I am laboring, standing here and speaking the word is all in vain for me and also for the people to whom I am giving this message. If you turn away from the truth, then all is in vain. That's what verse 11 is teaching us. Amen? Hence Paul is calling you and me today to stand fast to our freedom which Christ has bought for us. Even Jesus spoke, I don't remember the scripture in the book of Matthew, Jesus also spoke of the danger of human traditions. I think in the book of Matthew chapter 15, Jesus spoke about the danger of human traditions. Christ has delivered us from the need to keep human traditions. So Paul is calling today, stand firm in the freedom. We have been set free from the works of the flesh. Galatians chapter 5 verse 13 says, for you brethren have been called to liberty. Only do not use your liberty as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another. Why he says so? The answer is in Galatians 5:17. He says, for the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish. Amen? Christ is delivered from the deeds of the flesh, which endangers our salvation. If you go home and read, as I told you, Galatians, the book of Galatians, you will know what all the things of flesh that you and me are not supposed to indulge in. Amen? So that the freedom is not in danger. Hence, Paul is calling us today to stand firm in the freedom for which Christ has set us free. We are being called unto liberty, and Paul wants us to stand fast in that liberty where Christ has made us free. If you go home and read Galatians 5:19 completely, you will understand what I am saying. And we have also been set free from the law and the curse. Galatians chapter 3 verse 13 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who hangs on a tree. Yes. We are set free from every curse because Jesus bore our curse on the cross. Hallelujah. He nailed down every curse of yours and mine on the cross. If you agree with me, say amen. And Paul is calling us today to stand firm in the freedom where Christ has set us free from every curse. Galatians 3:22 says, but the scripture has confined all under sin. person, then that the promise by faith in Jesus Christ must be given to those who believe. Amen. So we are set free from the law and the curse because we stand in faith in Christ Jesus. The scripture says, if you stand in faith in Christ Jesus and believe the finished work of the cross, then Paul is saying, stand free, stand firm, stand fast in the freedom which you have received. Amen. Galatians 4:7 says, therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. Thanks to Jesus. Why don't you give a clap of him? You are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. Hence, Paul is calling us today to stand firm in the freedom and warning us not to be entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Now, what was the motive for Christ to set us free? Why he did it? I will say it was just for our freedom. Jesus wants us to live every day in the freedom that he has provided for you and me. We are no longer under the law of Moses, but rather under the provision of Christ. We are under the law of the Spirit. We are under the law of the Christ. We are under the law of liberty.
Yes.
I will show you the scriptures where it is written all the three laws. Romans chapter 8 verse 1 to 4 says, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made you what? Free.
Amen.
Amen. Law of the Spirit has made you and free. So we are no longer standing under the law of Moses, we are standing under the law of the Spirit. Amen. Verse 3 says, for what the law could not do in that it was weak through the flesh, God did by selling his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh. On account of sin, he condemned the sin in the flesh, that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Amen. Today, Paul is telling you and me, stand firm in that walk in the Spirit, law of the Spirit. Stand firm in the law of the Spirit and walk in the freedom, walk in the newness of life. Don't get entangled, don't get yoked to your old life again. Galatians chapter 6 verse 2 says, bear one another's burden and so fulfill what? The law of Christ. I told you that we belong to the law of Christ now, and the scripture reference is Galatians 6:2. And James chapter 1:25 says, but he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it, and is not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed what he does. Amen. If God has made you free to enter into the perfect law of liberty, let us be the doer of the word. And do not get entangled, do not get yoked with our old side of living. Amen. So today Paul is reminding us to stand firm in the freedom, not through the law of Moses, but because there is freedom in adhering to the law, rather stand firm in the freedom we have obtained through the law of Spirit, the law of Christ, and the law of perfect liberty. Amen. Then there arises a question. After having been set free by grace through faith, how should we feel about obeying God? Amen. I would say it's a great joy and passion to obey the Master who has set us free by shedding his blood on the cross. Romans chapter 7 verse 22 says, for I delight in the law of God according to the inward man. Amen. Now that our inward man is renewed and we are set free by the blood of Jesus, we delight to obey God and His word. Amen. We are called to obey God and His word once you are set free. As we are all not yet perfect, rather being perfected, we are in the process of perfection. Then again, there arises a question, is there a fear of judgment or wrath when we fail to obey the commandments? Amen. I would say absolutely not. John chapter 3 verse 18 says, he who believes in him is not condemned. Amen. But he who does not believe is condemned already. If you don't believe in Jesus, then you have to fear the wrath of God. Then you have to fear the judgment. If you are in belief in Christ Jesus and obeying his commandments, then there is no fear of wrath, there is no fear of judgment for you and me. Amen. If anybody in our midst today not believing in Jesus, today is the opportunity for you to give your life to Jesus, because there is no wrath of God, there is no judgment of God. If you walk in the newness of life according to the word, amen. Hallelujah. Today God is calling you and me to stand in that freedom of believing Jesus. Amen. So that we don't fall into judgment and wrath. Amen. And follow his ways. We should obey to bring glory to God. John chapter 3 verse 21 says, but those who do what is true come to the light in order that the light may show that what they did was in obedience to God. Amen. Whatever we do, it should bring glory to God. Then only it will be lightened. And what is happening? I mean, the people will know that whatever we are doing, it is for God. It is according to the will of God. It is according to the word of God. That is what the scripture is teaching me. Once again, Paul is reminding us today to stand fast to the freedom to do what is true and to do things in obedience to God. We don't obey to become saved. I repeat, we don't obey to become saved, but rather we are saved, so we want to obey. Amen. If you agree with me with this statement, then lay a loud amen. Amen. I say to you, we don't obey to become saved. We are saved, so we want to obey the God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So Paul gave command to the believers to keep standing firm. Standing firm in what? We should know how to set Christ-honoring standards for our own life. I've taken just two examples. Number one, do not sin. If you want to just stand firm in Christ, the freedom in Christ, number one, do not sin. And number two, do all for the glory of God. Amen. Amen. As the time is very short, I'm not going on to my second portion of this study. I'm just going to complete it here only. Let us read the relevant scripture for the point, do not sin. Romans chapter 5 verse 20 and 21 says, moreover, the law entered that the offense might abound. But when sin abounded, grace abounded much more. Amen. When sin was abounding, grace also abounded much more. So today, again, there is an opportunity for every unbelievers who are not yet saved, who have not yet taken baptism. God is saying, if you are a sinner, never mind, my grace is sufficient for you today. Come to the knowledge of salvation. My grace is available for every sinner today. This is what God is telling.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Verse 21 says, so that as sin reigned in death, even so grace might reign through righteousness, through eternal life, through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. If sin is reigning, it is reigning for death. But righteousness is reigning for eternal life through Christ Jesus. Great to the strength of the enemy, so great to the strength of honor of our conqueror. Amen. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 6 verse 1 and 2 calls us to be dead to sin and alive unto God. I'm not reading the scripture. I'm just telling you, the scripture is calling you to be dead to sin and alive unto God. Amen. Because we already read Romans 6:18 that we are set free from every sin. Amen. Do all for the glory of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 31 says, so whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. Amen. Our aim in living life should be to see the glory of God. Yes. Paul is saying, since you are set free in Christ, whatever you do, be careful to do all for the glory of God alone. Amen. Hallelujah. We understand that word stand fast and steadfast is for our present time. What the second question is, I want to give you reference scriptures for the point B, like Galatians chapter 1. The second portion says, do not be entangled, do not get yoked up with the old life. I have a lot of reference scriptures for that, but I'm not going to give you because of the shortage of time. I'm going to just conclude the message by giving you the summary of what I have written. Amen. How does Christian liberty impact our past, our present, and our future joy of living for Jesus Christ? That was my question. How does Christian liberty impact our past, our present, our future? future joy of living for Jesus Christ. In the past, He set us free by His grace. That is what we learn today. In the present, He helps us to stand firm in truth. That also we read today. We have to stand firm in the freedom what Christ has given you and me. In the future, He prevents us from being subject again to a yoke of slavery that we did not cover today. That is the last point which is in my conclusion, that in the future He prevents us from being subject again to a yoke of slavery. If we truly thankful for the freedom that the death of Christ Jesus provided us, then we will aggressively apply the word of God in our life. This is what is my belief. Amen. We ought to be people who are joyfully obeying our risen Savior by avoiding any sin in our lives and by doing all for the glory of God alone. Amen. Because Bible says, for whatever things were written before were written for our learning, and I'm sure that whatever we have learned today, we will put it into practice and we will go and meditate upon all these scriptures read today, because through our patience and comfort of the scripture, we will have hope. Amen. I'm suggesting you to go home and read the book of Galatians completely. Amen. Then you will understand from what and all Christ has set us free. I have just covered little portion. If you go home and read, then you will know what and all the guilt I had before, what and all the sins I committed before, and I am free today. Amen. That is the freedom we are enjoying. Amen. I will request Talisa to come and do the final prayer and give benediction.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And thank you, Sir Padma, for giving your word, which is very close to my heart, which is very much required for us. Again, Colossians chapter 2, verse 15 and 16, we see God forgive our sins. He took those laws which we could not follow and He nailed it to the cross. We could not follow the old laws. So we now got grace to believe Him.
Yes.
Ephesians 2:8 says, by grace you are saved and not by works. Amen. God so loved us that He said, you cannot follow the law. I will fulfill the law. I will nail it to the cross. Now you just follow me. Be like me. Thank you, sister, for reminding us. Thank you that today, O God, we live in the era of grace, that we are not concerned that we are not able to follow the law as long as we follow you, Lord. Because every time we miss the law, Lord, there is your grace to save us. Forgiveness is in you, Lord. Lord, I thank you for this wonderful time which you have given us. Thank you, Lord, that you died for our sins. All those sins which happens when we cannot keep the old law, God.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, you nailed it to the cross and closed that chapter. And you opened the era of grace, God. We thank you, Lord, that everything of God wrong about us, we come to you, Lord, for to wash us clean, pure us, no Lord, that we can stand before the Almighty God and say, Lord, yes, we are your children. Galatians 4 says, we are the children of the Almighty God. Yes, Lord Jesus. Just by your grace, by the blood which you shed on us. Thank you, Jesus, for freeing us from all the 535 laws of God in the Old Testament. Thank you, Lord, we have only one law in front of us, Lord. Love your neighbor as yourself. Lord, your love fulfills every law which was there. The same love of God will fulfill our lives, God. Enable us, O God, to experience that love and to pass it on to us. Again, fulfilling what you have come here for. I thank you, Lord, for each one of us out here, God. That each one of us will remember this, O God. That you nailed the Lord to the cross, will not look back, will not go to the vomit again.
Yes,
we look forward to you, Lord Jesus,
yes,
the author and the finisher of our faith.
Hallelujah.
We thank you and bless you. Bless us, Sir Padma.
Yes, Lord.
All these weeks she has been laboring, O God, to preach the word, O God. Bless the abundantly, O God. Fulfill the desires of our heart, O God. All those who have heard her are blessed. In Jesus' name I pray.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Lord, I thank you, Lord. Amen. Once again. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. May the love of the Father, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and all the things we pray for and forever. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. Amen.